says when Yaakov Kohen la'alfin einin la'ainin alfin, the letter ayin and the letter aleph were often interchanged. So therefore, the word el and al are also interchangeable. So when it says el Hashem, it also means al Hashem. Today, Rabbi Amnei Amri Mehocha, it says v'di zahav. This is what does it say in the pasuk? Eila hadvar mashir dibe Moshe al kol Yisrael beiva yaidin ba midba ba rava moelsof bein poinu beitavu v'lo machatzis v'di zahav, and they had enough gold. They had a lot of wealth. My v'di zahav. Amri dibe Rabbi Amnei kach Amri Moshe lefnei Hakadosh Baruch Hu. This is what Moshe told Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Ribono shel Olam, you know why they did averus? You messed them up. If you give your children too much, they're going to be lazy, unproductive people, and they're going to get into trouble. B'shvil kesef v'zov sheshpat lehem liYisrael. You gave them so much money till the point where they said, enough, we have so much money already, we have enough. I don't know anyone who ever said that. Who goram sha'asos egel? That caused them to make the egel. If they wouldn't have had so much money, they wouldn't have done the egel. Rabbi Shalom, I understand, but you don't have to go to the other extreme. Work with me. Amri Dvei Rabbi Yani said, Ein ari noihem mitech kupa shal teven. An ari will not roar after eating mere teven, meaning when do we get our gall and our bravery to go do a veris? That's only if we're overfilled. Rashi says noy means sameich, he's happy, and then umishtageya, he goes crazy, umazek, and he damages. So by us having too much gashmius, we get ourselves into trouble. Amar Boishia, Moshe la'odom, shahoyse le par kchusha ubala sevarim. He had a weak para and ubala sevarim. And what happened? What he did, it was a skinny para. Hechila kashinan, he gave it to eat, and now it became strong. Suddenly, voice of Adas boy, and now it's causing trouble, it's getting wild. Amar la, he told him, mi gorim loch tehei, mevaetis bi, ele kashin shachalticha. What caused you to make trouble here? Because I fed you. In other words, if I give you too much, it ends up that you misbehave. He had a son, and you know what? He gave the son too much. He washed him, and he smeared him, and he gave him to eat good, and he gave him to drink. In other words, he made sure that he was a really good-looking guy, all spiffed up, clean, and gepashit. And then the Talalai kiss al Tzavari, and he hung a kiss on his neck. I'm not sure, I assume it means besamim. Oh, Moli Mois, full of money. So he gave him his gold cards, his platinum visa, and he put him into a great danger. And then where did he put him? Vaishivoi al Pesach Shozainis. Ma Yase Oisa Ben Shalayata. What do you expect from such a child? He grows up. Which, with such decadence, is, of course, is going to cause it to do averus. Amr Rab Acha Bereid Rav Huna Amr Pesheshes Hanid Amr Inchi Malik Kreisei Zoni Bishi. Your stomach is full. Rashes Milu Akeres Hu Mimine Chatom Haroim. That's bruised trouble. Shenemar Kemar Isam. You were pastured. You were full. Vayisbu Savu, and then you became very satisfied. And what does that lead to? Vayarim Libam. Now you became haughty, al kein shechachuni. Rab Nachman Amar Mahacha, v'ram levavcha, v'shechachta es Hashem. You see a similar concept that when you get too haughty, that's when you start forgetting Hashem. Rabban Amar Mahacha, Rabban say you learn from this, v'achal, v'sava, and then v'doshein, upana. And then you rebel and you turn away. V'bayisem Mahacha, v'yishman Yeshurun, Yeshurun became fat, v'yivat, and then they were boyit, they rebelled. They rejected the mitzvahs. Amar Shmuel by Nachmeni, Amar Bjornison, Minayin Shechazer Kadosh Baruch Hu V'hoyde Eloi L'Moshe. How do you know that Hashem was moedi to Moshe? In fact, that it's not Klal Yisrael's fault. It's because Hashem gave us too much. Shenemar V'kesef R'beis Yilahem, and then V'zohav Asu L'Bal. V'yidah B'Shem Moshe, Leich Reid, go down. What did it mean, go down? So Moshe was on Har Sinai. Klal Yisrael did the eagle, and then Hashem told Moshe, go down. So Pashup Shad is, go down from the mountain. My Leich Reid. Omer b'losh, Omer l'akadosh baruch hu Moshe, Moshe reid migidulascha. You lost your stature. You are the great leader of Klal Yisrael. Now that your Klal Yisrael has went down, you're down too. Klum nasati lach gedula, ele b'shvil Yisrael. Why did I give you glory? Only because you're representing Klal Yisrael. V'achshav Yisrael chatu, now that Klal Yisrael did an aveira, lo malach gedula. The Bach changes this, lo malach gedula. So miyad toshes koyche shel Moshe, right away Moshe Rabbeinu became weak. V'lehoye lekoyech ledaber, he couldn't even speak. He was speechless. V'chivin d'shomar, and then Hashem told him something else. An interesting comment Hashem said, harif mimeni v'ashmidim, bug off, let go of me so that I can destroy them. So Moshe says, oh, that's like a signal to me that you need me to sort of authorize you to destroy them. You need me to stop bothering you. So obviously, I have a hope here. I'm Moshe Dover Zeh Tali B. I see that I'm involved here. Miyad Omad V'nishchazak B'tfila U'vikish Rachamim. When I do collections, I tell my secretary to send a fax every day, not an email, but a fax every day to this business that owes me money. So a fax comes out, everybody in the office sees it, and the boss is embarrassed. If I get an angry call, why are you faxing me? Then I tell my secretary, fax him twice a day. Because obviously, it's working. He told, hey, the moment they say, harif mimeni, then I can double down on my efforts. Moshe lemelech basar v'dom, the Bach sticks in. Shekos al-Bunah, he got angry on his son. He was hitting him really hard. So the king was hitting his own son. And the king's friend, Yoshev Lefanov, was sitting there, and he would have loved to intervene, but he's afraid to intervene when the king is punishing his son. And then while the king is punishing his son, the king says, Amar Melech, if it wasn't for my friend here watching me, causing me to restrain myself, Haraktich, I'd kill you. Amar, right away the friend realized, Dover Zatali B. Obviously the king is listening to me. Miyad Amad Vetziloi, he came and he rescued his son's prince. Vata Nichali. Now Hashem told Moshe, stop bothering me. Vayichar Api Bohem, and I will become angry in them. Vachalim, I'll destroy them. But you know what? Vesais Cholagai Gadol, I'll make you into a great nation. Amrabavo, Il Mole Mikra. Kosev, if it wasn't for this pasuk written, you wouldn't be able to say what I'm about to say. Hashem said, "Anichel, let go me." Malamed, it teaches us shetofsi Moshe laKadosh Baruch Hu. Moshe went to Rabbi Yisrael and he grabbed him by the lapels. Normally it says "Vereizes Achora Yifonei LeHiro," but here he had adrenaline and he jumped up to save Klal Yisrael and he grabbed Hashem by the lapels and says, "You're not doing nothing to my nation." I will not let go of you until you're going to be Moichel Klal Yisrael. Hashem dangled in front of Moshe a very great opportunity. I could build a nation out of you. So Rabbi Elazar tells us, Moshe said, Hashem, I wasn't born yesterday. I know the deal here. Klal Yisrael has the schus of three avos. U'makise shel shalosh regalim. Klal Yisrael has such a foundation of three avos. Eino yachal lamed lefanecha b'shas kascha. They can't stand in front of you when you're angry. You think my children are never going to do anything wrong? Kise shel regal echad. If you're relying only on me, alachas kama v'kama. Fregin ala rishonim. Does Moshe Rabbeinu not also have Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov? Is he not also a descendant of Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov? Now he has four legs. So there's different tshuvas, but the main answer is, if the Rebbe Shalom wipes out Klal Yisrael, that also takes with it the schus ofis. It's also very embarrassing. Here, like I told them I'm going to take over, and like now, it's like a liberal politician. You know, I campaign that I'm going to do everything great for the nation, and then all I do is I go on vacation to Cuba a whole day while the economy is hitting the bricks, hitting the skids. Achshav Yoimer, Ruhu Parnis, Shamidu Aleim. Look at this leader that they elected. Bakish Gdud Al Atzmoy. All he cared was getting reelected and glorifying his own name. V'loi Bikash Aleim Rachamim. He abandoned them and he only looked to benefit on his own.
But who's going to have this taina? Who's going to have this taina call your soul's God?
The Avos. Yeah, my Avos, yeah. Yeah. Vayichal Moshe es Pnei Hashem. So this is the parasha that we lay in on every Tanis Tibur. Moshe Rabbeinu beseeched the Rebbeinu Shalom. Amar Rabbi Elazar, Melamed, Sha'amad Moshe betfilah lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu ad shechaleu. He went after Hashem until hechaleu, Rashi means hifzer boy. He was really bothering him and pressuring him. For Rabbi Amar, ad shehafa lo nidroi, until it made Hashem be matter his nether. Hashem made a nether of va'achalim. I will destroy them. So Moshe says, we'll be mad to your nether. Ksevacha va'yichal. Ksevachasim lo'yachal dvara. You see, it's a lotion of de-sanctifying the nether. V'amemar, hu einei mechal, aval acher machum lo'y. Other people could be mad to the nether. Shmuel amar, melamed shemosa asma l'misa aleim. Moshe Rabbeinu sacrificed himself over it. Shnemar v'im'ayin mecheni na misifrecha. How does that help? Because Moshe Rabbeinu said, Misa tzaddikim is mechaper. So I'm willing to sacrifice myself to save Klal Yisrael. Omer Rav Omer Bitzuk, Malamet Shehechla Aleim Midas Rachamim, Rashi's Hechla is Yachulu Al Roshayiv, Haniach, he placed upon them Midas Rachamim. Rabban Amar, Malamet Shomer, Moshe Lefnak, Alish Baruch, Rabban Yisraelim, Chulun Hulach Me'asoyz Kedover Azeh. It's beneath you, it's Chulun, it's a lack of Kedusha for you to do such a thing as to destroy Klal Yisrael. Vayichal Moshe's Pnei Hashem. Tanya Rabbi Lazar Agod Loimer. Malamet Shomet Moshe B'Tfila Lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Moshe was davening so stark, at Shechzosoi Achilu, until he suffered the condition called Achilu. My Achilu, what is that condition? Omer Rabbi Lazar, Eishel HaTomois, it's a fire of the bones. Ma Eishel HaTomois, Omer Abaye, Ashto the Garmi, a very high fever. Mular Balaz is what, Mular is Kadachas, it's very hot. Choyli Shemichamemes V'Koydeches Esaguf. Then he said, Zechor Avram Litzach L'Yisrael Avodecha Asher Nishpat Alehem Bach. My Bach? What's Bach? Omer Rabbi Lezer, Omer Moshe Lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Omer Moshe Lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Rabbi Shalom, El Mole Nishpat Alehem, B'Shemayim Uvaretz, if you would have swore to them in the name of the heaven and earth, then Hayisi Omer, I would have said, Kishem Shemayim Uvaretz B'Telem, just like Shemayim Uvaretz will eventually become bottle, Kach Shavu Atzcha B'Telah, so to your Shavu can be bottle, but you swore in yourself. Va'achshav nishpat lehem b'shimcha gadol. Ma shimcha gadol chai v'kayem lo'olam ulo'olam ulo'olamim. Kach shivu oscha kayemes lo'olam ulo'olam ulo'olamim. You made a very dangerous shvur. This is a real, real problem. But I'm sorry, for carrot. You made a shvur that's lo'olam ulo'olam to be with them. That's your bris, so you may not abandon them. Va'tadaber aleihem arbe zarchem k'choich v'ashamayim. You told them that you would be marbi their children. So it says amarti, but it's Hashem talking. Moshe is quoting Hashem, so he should have said asher amarti. Asher amarta mi ba'yli. If Moshe Rabbeinu is quoting the Rabban Shlomo, it says asher amarta. Amar blazer atkan the Talmud up until this point. That was Moshe talking. And then Hashem jumped in, because Hashem was already mefuyis, and he said, V'chol ha'orz ha'zot asher amarti, mikan ve'lech tevei Rav. Rabbi Shmuel bar Nachmani Omar, Eilu ve'Eilu divrei Talmud. These are both the words of Moshe Rabbeinu. Lekach Omar Moshe lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Ribono shel Olam, Devarim shamarta li, the words that you told me, Lech emor lehem li Yisrael b'shmi. So all the many, many things Moshe Rabbeinu said, you sent me from the sneh. From the sneh you sent me to say things over in your name. So halachti v'amarti lam b'shimcha. I said all those things in your name. Achshav mani oimerlem. What am I supposed to tell them? So v'chol ha'aretz hazot asher amarti, Moshe Rabbeinu says, I taka told Klal Yisrael about the aretz hazot, but I told it to them in a shlichus from you. And now, what am I supposed to tell them? All the words that I said are lies. B'milti yecholas Hashem. Nations are going to say that it was from Hashem's lack of ability that he destroyed us in the Midbar. So it shouldn't say mibilti yecholas Hashem. It should say mibilti yochol Hashem mibayi. Hashem couldn't do it mibayi. Omar Blazer, Omar Moshe Lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ribono Shel Olam. Achshav, now yomer umos ha'olam. The umos are going to say tashas koichoi k'nekeva. You're like a mother that gave birth, and now she's very weak. And after taking us out of Mitzrayim, which was a huge trauma, you could no longer go on. You could no longer sustain us. Veni yochol atzel. Omar HaKadosh Baruch Hu Moshe. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu told Moshe, I don't think you got to worry about that. Because even after they came out of Mitzrayim, I doubled down on my koiches. So no one's going to say that when Klal Yisrael left, Mitzrayim was like childbirth. But the nations could still say something derogatory, and that is, yes, you were able to stand up to Pyrrhi. But getting Klal Yisrael into Eretz Yisrael is too daunting a task, because there's many kings involved that you would have to conquer. And that's why Moshe Rabbeinu was pressuring the Baruch Shalom to be Moichel Klal Yisrael. How do we know that Hashem conceded to Moshe's Taina? Shenemar v'yomer Hashem salachti kidvarecha. I'm being salach l'Yisrael because of your words. Tani devei Rabbi Shmuel kidvarecha. What does that mean? Asidim umas ha'olam loymer kein. Eventually the umas ha'olam are going to say, Ashrei Talmud sh'rabbi moideloi. Lucky is a Talmud that his Rebbe agrees to his arguments. V'ulam chai ani, but Hashem goes weiter and says, V'ulam chai ani, v'yimolech v'ad Hashem eskola aretz. Amar Rav Amar B'Yitzchok, Malam Shomer l'Hakadosh Baruch Hu Moshe, Moshe hachisani b'dvarecha, hachisani Rashi b'fnei ha'umos. You made me my name alive. You made my name alive. You gave me tchias ha'mesim in front of the umos, meaning you made me do the right thing, which would show the umos ha'olam that I'm a stronger Ribbono Shel Olam. First, a person should say Pesukah de Zimra. And only then should he daven. Minalan, where do you find this concept? Mi Moshe. Tichsiv v'aschanan el Hashem bo'esahi. I davened to Hashem in that time. Uchsiv Hashem alakim atachi loisa. L'haris is avdecha. Es godlecha v'siyotcha chazaka. Asher mikael b'shemaimu v'oretz. Asher yaseh chamaisecha v'chugvoresecha. So first, what was Moshe's tefillah? First, he praised Hashem, and then Uchsiv Basrei, Ebronov, Eres, Haret, Hatoiva, and then Moshe came in for the kill shot. Then he came in to ask the Ribbono Shel Olam for the bakasha that he'd had. Simon, the next Gemara, is going to involve Maisim, Tzedakah, Karbin, Koyin, Tainis, Minol, and Barzal. Zok Tehelige, Gemara, Viter. Omar Belozer, Rabbi Belozer said, Gedoyle tefillah, Yoisim and Maisim Toiv. Tefillah is greater than Maisim Toiv. Rashi and Tosis tells us, G'day l'tefillah Yoisim Maisim Toiv beloy tefillah. Tefillah is greater than Maisim Toiv without tefillah. But of course, both together are the best. Zok to Gemara. She'ein lach gadol b'Maisim Toiv Yoisim and Moshe Rabbeinu. There was no greater person who did more Maisim Toiv than Moshe Rabbeinu. And Afal Pikein lo'inena ela b'tefillah, he didn't get answered from Hashem only when he broke into tefillah. Shenemar al toisef daber elai. Hashem said, "Don't talk to me anywhere about this." V'samach lei alei raisha piska. So you see, it was the daber elai, it was the tefillah that Moshe Rabbeinu did that broke through to make Hashem be moichlem. From Rabbi Elazar, Gedoyle tainis yoshim in atzedaka. Oh right, sorry, that was about. Don't bother me anymore about going to Eretz Yisrael,
yeah,
and then Hashem gave in a little bit through tefillah that he can at least go look at Eretz Yisrael. V'amar Rabbi Elazar, G'doy l'tainis yoysim na tzedakah. Fasting is greater than giving tzedakah. My time is zeh v'gufoy v'zeh b'mamoynoy. We learned earlier that for keret, the schar of tainis is the money that you give to tzedakah, that you give to the aniyim. So there's different pshatim in it. One of the pshatim is that in Olam Hazeh, the schar is for the moment, for the tzedakah. But in Olam Haba, we get schar for the fasting itself. Tefillah is greater than karbonos. Shneimar, lama li roiv zevchechem. The pasuk says, lama li roiv zevchechem. Why do I need all of your karbonos? Lama li roiv zevchechem. Yoyimar Hashem. Savati oilois elim vechelev marim v'damparim ukvasim v'atudim lechavotzi. I don't need all that. And then the next pasuk says, "Uvifarischem kapechem alim einemikem." And then when you daven, I'm going to not listen to you. So it says, if karbonis are greater than tefillah, then once Hashem said, "I don't need your karbonis," so obviously I'm going to ignore your tefillah. Hashem said, "I'm going to ignore your karbonis, and I'm even going to ignore your tefillah." So you see, tefillah is more powerful than the karbonis. Amar Beyichin, Kalgoyin Shahargas Hanefesh, Akoinu killed, Lo Yises Kapav, he may no longer duchen, Shnemer Yedechim and Domim Malu, your hands are full of blood. And I think that's when Hashem told him, right, so Einenu Shemer Yedechim Domim Malu, it says in Yeshaya. There's a whole Shaila, if Akoinu did kill, could he do tshuva or not? It's a mashma even after tshuva. So there were Shailas, Kohanim, that were in the army and had to kill people. So there was also a very interesting shaila that was brought to the Maram of Rajan, where a Kohen had a temper and he got angry at somebody in shul, and he took the menorah and he threw it at a guy, and it knocked him out, and the guy got sick. He didn't die instantly, but he never recovered, and he eventually died. And the shaila was, can you allow this Kohen to duchen? So the Maram paskened that, first of all, we can't be 100% sure that it was the menorah that killed him, because it didn't happen right away. And if he does tshuva, we'll let him duchen again. Are there any kohanim here? Don't try that.
He acted as a kohen at the Hanukkah. Rabbeinu himself was a cup.
But he was never laces cup.
Right. He didn't do it. Yeah, it doesn't say he can't do the void. It says lo yisus kapov. Yeah. So the poskim say if he killed because he was in the army, then it's called an oinus. So there's no problem. Okay. Yeah. As I'm Rabbi Blazer. Miyom shechar beis hamikdash. From the time the beis hamikdash was charved, nin alu shari tefila. The shari tefila have been closed. Shenemar gam ki ezek vasheveya. Even though I'm screaming and crying, shasam tefilasi. My tefila is blocked. Va'avu bishu shari tefila nin alu. Nevertheless, shari dima lo nin alu. The sharim of tears have never closed. Shenemar shema tefilasi Hashem. V'shavasi azina el dim osi al techrash. It's my tears that stop Hashem from ignoring us. And Tosis speaks out and he clarifies Rashi, who says midloy kamer b'damasi tira. It didn't say look at my tears. Shemami nashe nirus b'chol pam. The Rebbeinu Shlom always sees our tears. Ve'ein lehispal rakshet eskabel. The tefila was the masi al techrash. Don't ignore them, but you for sure see them. The question is, we've cried so much throughout the generations, and what's going on? We're not getting help. So Rav Elfin spoke out from the Gedolim that we cry for our personal sorrows. That's not what breaks through. If we all cry in unison because of Shechinta Begalusa, we want the Gula, then Avada Hashem would listen. And he said over a fascinating story. You know, the bells of Beis Medrash that we know of in Eretz Yisrael, this magnificent edifice, is actually a duplicate of the bells of Beis Medrash that the Sar Shalom built in actually the city of bells. And when they built the building, they had finished the main Beis Medrash for the men to daven before they finished Ezra's Noshim. And the Belzer Rebbe would not let them move in to use it while they were completing Ezra's Noshim. And he said it's because of this Gemara. It's to tears that sustain Klal Yisrael. And most of the tears that are cried in Shul are cried in the Ezra's Noshim. Because of that, we cannot move into a Beis Medrash before we have the Ezra's Noshim prepared. Rav Elazar Tanisa B'yom, the Sar Shalom, in Bells, in the city of Bells.
But here they allow them to use it.
I don't know about here. I don't know. It's right. Rav, I don't know if you know, when they built the Beis Medrash in Bells, the Rebbe said, Baruch HaKodesh, that there's a direct line from this Beis Medrash to the Mokum of the Evan Shasiyah to the Mokum of the Kodesh Kodeshim, and there's no church in a direct line. So when they built the building in Yerushalayim, they also did it with the same Ruach HaKodesh, except the Ruach HaKodesh that they used was a GPS, a satellite. And they also, there's a direct line from there to the Mokum Kodesh Kodeshim without any churches in the line of sight. Rava would not go to Tanisim on cloudy days because he felt it wasn't a good day to be mispal. It's not a good day. You covered it up with a cloud to stop tefillah. And Rebbe Elephant explained very nicely. What did they daven for most of the time in those days? They daven for rain. So if it's a nice, bright, sunny day, you daven for rain. But if it's a cloudy day and it's not raining, Hashem's not listening to you that day. Because it's already cloudy, right? And it's not raining, so that's not a good time. Vam Rabbi Lozer, V'yom Shechar Beis HaMikdash, from the time the Beis HaMikdash was charved, Nifsika Choymas Barzel Ben Yisrael Avim Shemashamayim. There's not an iron curtain, but an iron wall is now being mafsik between Klal Yisrael and their Father in Heaven. Shenemer V'ata Kach Lecha Machvas Barzel, take a platter of steel, V'nosata Oysa Kir Barzel Ben Chol V'Neir. So you see that once the Beis HaMikdash was Chorev, there's like an iron curtain between us and the Rebbeinu Shlom. Amar Bchana, Amar Bchanina, Kol Marech B'Tfilosai. If someone is Marech on his Tfilah, Ain't Tfilosai Chazeres Rekim. He's for sure going to be answered from his Tfilah. Minolan, where do we know this? Mimoy Sherbeinu Shenemar Vespal Al Hashem. He said, I'm going to daven to Hashem. Uchsiv Basrei, Vayishma Hashem Eilai, Gam Bapam Ahi. Hashem listened to me also on that time. Zok to Heilige Gemara, ain't that so? Amar B'chir Bar Abba, Amar B'echin Kol Marech B'Tfilosim Ma'ayin Ba. So he's looking, when is Hashem going to answer my tefillah? When am I going to get what I asked for? Bode kevlev, he just causes some heartache because he's not going to get his bakasha answered. So you see, marach with philosophy is not a good thing. Shnever techeles mimushcha machalev. So draw it out tefillah just causes you heartache. My tekante, how do you fix that if you do that? Yasek b'toyra. Shnever ve'etz chayim, if you learn from the etz chayim, Taiva ba, you'll get what you want. But al kopan, we have a stira. Is it good or is it not good? So it's more like Asha. How the marich ma'ain ba? If your marich and your ma'ain in it, and Tosva says it means that you're yearning. When will Hashem do what I asked? When will Hashem do what I asked? That's not good. But how the marich ma'ain ba? But if your marich and tefillah and you daven more, not just saying when will Hashem do what I want, then you'll have a kabbalah of tefillah. What happens if a person sees someone davening and he wasn't answered? Yachzor, if a person davens and he sees he's not answered, Yachzor is well, she's davening again. Shnemer kavei el Hashem, chazak v'yam shlebecho v'kavei el Hashem. So Rabbi Elifin asks, I don't understand. If it didn't work the first time, what makes him think it's going to work the second time? So what did he say? So the Vilna Gaon says, what this means is, it doesn't mean you should daven again. It means you should listen to Chazoras Hashatz, and you should answer Amen to every bracha. That's what the Gemara means when the Gemara says that Yachshav Yispal. Tanar Bon, Abot Shrichin Chizuk. Four things need Chizuk. Ve'eloin, and these are them. Torah, Umaisim Toivim, Tefillah, V'derech Eretz. And Rashi's Derech Eretz means, Im Omen Hulum Nasai, if you're an Omen, you should take retraining. You should always look for good products to sell. He should take new self-defense courses or develop new weapons. How do you know this? And we learned chazek is referring to the Torah, and the ametz is referring to ma'asim toivim. So you always have to strengthen yourself for davening. You have to go to these self-improvement courses. You have to constantly reinvigorate yourself with motivation. Tzion said Hashem abandoned me, and also Hashem shechachani, and he forgot me. Hainu azuva, hainu shchucha. If we're abandoned, we're forgotten. What's the double lashon? Amar Rish Lakish, Amar Knesset Yisrael of Nekadosh Baruch Hu. Ribono Shel Olam. Adam Noisi Isha Lishta Rishona. If someone marries a second wife to replace his first wife, Zoicher Ma'aseh Rishona. He always remembers the ma'aseh of his first wife. In other words, the famous story where a guy divorces his wife, and right after the divorce, he says, "How about we get married again?" She said, "You just divorced me." He said, "Yeah, for the first wife, you're not good, but for Zivik Sheni, you're not bad." Because a person always remembers his first wife is better. But Ata Azavtani, you abandoned us, Vishachtani, and you totally forgot us. Amalek HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I forgot you? Let me tell you something. Biti, Mantai Tachter, Yudbeis Mazolos Barasu Barakia. He made 12 Mazolos, connected 12 months, and connected 12 Shvatim. So I designed my universe around Klal Yisrael. V'alkol Mazol Mazol Barasu Lo Shloshim Chayol, 30 Chayolim. V'alkol Chayol V'chayol Barasu Lo Shloshim Ligyon. Valko ligyon viligyon brasil shloshim rehatoin. Valko rehatin verhatin brasil shloshim kartoin. Valko kartin verkartin brasil shloshim gistera. Valko gistera vigistera talisaboy shalosh meres vishishim vechamisha 365,000 alfei riboy, not thousand, tens of thousands. Koychovim. So these are numbers that are above my grasp. No, alfei riboy. Time, yeah. Kenegi yimashacham vechulam. My whole the universe is designed around you. Vata mata azavtani ushachtani, and I think Rashi says about all these things, ligi and karten gistera are shema shel srora. There are different levels of authority of his malachim. So haltishkach isha, will a woman forget? Let me read haltishkach isha ula. Meirachem ben Bitna, I will never forget my children. Omer Kadosh Baruch Hu klum eshkach, can I possibly forget? Oilois Eilim, Oilois Eilim, upitre rechamim de bechoyrish, shekrafta lefanei bemidbar. Omer lefanei verbonye shloilim, hoil vein shikha, okay, so you take remember it. Hoil vein shikha lefnechishach vedecha, maybe that's not such a good thing. Shema loishtishkach limais haegel. You might now, if you're saying you have such a good memory, you can remember the bad things also. Amar lo, he told him, no, no, gam eila tishakachna. I'll forget that. And eila, Rashi says, is referring to the Maisa Egel, where Klal Yisrael said, eila elekecha Yisrael. Amar lefan of Rabbanu Shlomo. Well, now if you're saying you do forget, maybe you're going to forget Maisa Sinai and you'll abandon me. Amar lo, v'anoichi lo yeshkechacha, and Rashi says, anoichi is going on anoichi, Hashem elekecha, by the Aseret HaDibros. V'ayin d'amar b'lazer m'avayshia ma'idich siv gam eilu t'shukachna zeh ma'isa egel v'anoichi lo eshkechecha zeh ma'isa sinai. V'amar b'shua ben Levi ha'mespa'al tzorech l'shay shah achas achet filosoi. Someone who davens has to remain after his tefillah. That's why we have aleinu. We have different things after Shmonesri because we stay a little bit. Shedemar ach tzadikim yoidu l'shmecha yeshiv yishar v'espanecha. The mefarshim asks before you have to be there to get yourself into the mindset of davening. Why after? So there's different svaris. The R scroll brings down the difference. One is during davening you make kabbalas to improve yourself, you have to review what you accomplished by davening and you have to hold on to it and put it into action. I'm sorry? I skipped a line. Chasidim Rishon Yishayin Chasachas Milan Amili. I'm sorry. Amar Bishur Ben Levi Amakra Ashrei Yoshev Vesecha. It says Ashrei Yoshev Vesecha. V'amar Bishur Ben Levi, so let's stop here, but I just want to speak out that actually the pasuk of Pesukim Zimri is Tehillah L'David. Why do we stick in the pasuk Ashrei, which is not part of that same capital? It's because Ashrei Yoshev V'Secha Oydei L'Chasela, to remind us that we're supposed to sit before davening and prepare ourselves. It's this Gemara that explains why we say the pasuk of Ashrei before the capital of Tehillah L'David. Okay, let's stop here.
So
that's right. Why do we say Tehillah L'David? Because of Ashrei Yoshev V'Secha. Shkoyach.